Now, if you're planning to jet away anytime soon, you might want to ponder this. Would you be comfortable stepping on the scales?
That's what's happening over the next 5 weeks as Air New Zealand asks passengers to weigh in.
Bags checked in, passport ready, a quick bite.
Kia ora, good morning, ladies and gentlemen.
Now another step added to the process of boarding your flight.
Air New Zealand is conducting a survey to measure the average weight of passengers, including hand luggage.
Wait, did I hear right?
Measure the average weight of passengers.
What is this, the biggest loser? Well, in fact, this is not new. Our national carrier conducted the survey a few years back, surprising one of our very own in the terminal, who tweeted, "That won't be embarrassing at all." A sentiment echoed by travellers bound for Korea.
Actually, I'm surprised.
Find it a bit discriminating, but a bit insulting, to be honest.
Baggage. Is that what you're talking about?
No, you. Oh. They're going to weigh you. They're asking to weigh you.
Uh-oh, I've just eaten. That's a bad sign.
Under pressure. So, can you wing it, or, like your bags, have to scale back?
And Alistair James is Air New Zealand's load control specialist. Great to talk to you, Alistair. I can see this causing some fear and embarrassment. Why is it so important to weigh passengers?
It's important because we need to know the weights of everything that go on board our aircraft. And for passengers or customers, crew and their cabin bags, we use an average weight, and that average weight comes from this survey.
Do you think you could give us a quick demonstration of how it works?
Yeah, for sure, I can do that. It's quite straightforward, really. We have two sets of scales here. You stand on this one, and the team will get you to put your bags on this one. Mm-hmm. And on this side here, we've got a laptop, and the weights are captured, and then you're good to go.
OK, so just let me clarify this. There's not a big number coming up on a screen for everyone in the airport to see.
No, nothing appears at all anywhere. As you can see, there's nothing like your bathroom scales at all.
No.
OK, Alistair, so the computer captures your weight. Does anyone else see it at all? Where does the info go?
It just goes straight into, as I say, into the computer. Nobody sees anything. On the screen over here, they literally put whether you're an adult or a child, and the computer captures it, and that's it. All done. You can carry on with the rest of your day.
And is the weigh-in compulsory? I'm not trying to get out of it. I'm happy to do it. But for those who really don't want to get on the scales, is it compulsory?
No, not at all. It's purely voluntary.
And, Alistair, I know that you conduct the survey every 5 years. Is there a trend in average weights? I mean, are we getting heavier as a population?
What can I say? I would love to tell you, but a gentleman doesn't tell.
Well, I know the stats from every other health organisation, and I think we are generally getting heavier. And, Alistair, how long will the weigh-in go for? Do you need a specific number of people to take part?
Yes, we do. We need to get at least 10,000 people to get a reasonable sample of the travelling public.
How many people did you capture today, for example?
Yeah, we've got two sets of scales, and today we think we caught about 400 or so passengers.
Alistair, I'm just looking behind you on your left there, and that looks like a basket. Has that got lollies in it?
It has. It's got lollies, and we tried to put those out to encourage people to come forward.
Looks like the basket's nearly empty, so it looks like people have taken the lollies.
Yeah, I reckon every single one of the 400 must have had one.
Thanks for your time, Alistair. All the best.
Thank you.